were so many stories floating around there, human stories, non-human stories. We as human beings have a responsibility to catch those stories, to see it as a story, to transform it, and to tell that story.
So my story is that I grew up not far away in the town of Gustavus, very remote, only about 400 people. Gustavus is embedded within Glacier Bay National Park. That's what brought my parents there. And so I grew up incredibly lucky to be exploring this vast wilderness around us and to be imbued with this environmental ethic. I eventually headed off to California for college and for graduate school. My PhD studies at Stanford University were about polar biology. I was studying the way that climate change affects the polar marine ecosystems of both the Arctic and the Antarctic. It was amazing to go to the polar regions. I was out drilling ice cores, taking water samples, running around with polar bears and penguins. But as my PhD progressed, I became really filled with this compulsion to not just document the problems of this world, but to actively work in my own way to change those problems, to reverse some of the disturbing trends that we observe here.
Right with right, left with left. Right with right, left with left.
When this property, the Hobbit Hole, came up for sale, it was like a lightning bolt. What if I could turn that place into an institute for education and research and bring student groups here to share with them this amazing place that inspired me as a child? Wouldn't that be an amazing way to give back and to try to make a difference in this world? When I finished my PhD in the spring of 2014, I set off on this big, crazy trek up the coast. I walked from Stanford University to Port Angeles, Washington, and then I kayaked all the way from Port Angeles up the Inside Passage to the Hobbit Hole. I paddled right in through that cove on my 111th day on August 30 of 2014. It was a really amazing way to come home, an amazing way to return to my homeland and spread the word towards building this dream.
It's been amazing being here this week.
I was born and raised in Southeast Alaska. I think it's nice to be in this incredible place with a group of people that are equally as charged or more charged.
I'm originally from Georgia, but I'm living in Juneau for the summer, and I'm here to take a course in environmental rhetoric through the Inian Islands Institute. Language is one of the best ways that we have to connect with other people. And so if you understand how to use it and how to use it with compassion and care and with an environmental ethic, then it's super valuable.
But something that I'm excited about in this state is just being surrounded by people who are watching and understanding the changes in the environment and how those changes in the environment will become changes in our cultures and changes in our communities.
I think that fierce love of place can be really powerful when those places are changing so drastically and so quickly.
It was a difficult decision to walk away from an academic career path and go off on this much more uncertain path that was going to take me down roads that I knew not where. But for me, it just came to me in the form of having grown up here, being compelled to come back, and having this place come up for sale. It's like it was preordained. when you educate, it's like blowing seeds in the wind. You never know where they're going to land, where they're going to take root, or what beauty is going to come of that. All you know is that you're creating a bigger difference than you could possibly ever do on your own.
It's cool because it's like the things that make you feel the best also are the solutions. That's what it's going to take, is people really loving the world and like loving each other and loving their community and then fighting for that.
Thank you.